Good morning and welcome you all to this session of solving problem on steam nozzle. Problem 5. Estimate the mass flow rate of steam in a nozzle with the following data. Inlet pressure and temperature equal to 10 bar and 200 degrees centigrade. Back pressure equal to 0.5 bar. Throat diameter equal to 12 millimeter. In this problem, the throat diameter is given, so we have to consider a convergent-divergent nozzle. The cross-section of a nozzle first decreases from its entrance to throat and then increases from its throat to exit. So this type of nozzle is known as convergent divergent nozzle. The section where the cross sectional area is minimum is called throat of the nozzle. The portion 1, that is convergent portion, steam enters the nozzle with high pressure but with a negligible velocity. Thus there is no pressure drop in the steam pressure with a rise in its velocity. There is also a drop in enthalpy or total heat of the steam. This drop of the heat is not utilized for external work, but it is converted into kinetic energy. In the portion 2, that is divergent portion, there is a further drop of steam pressure with a rise in its velocity. Again, there is a drop in the steam enthalpy or total heat of the steam, which is converted into kinetic energy. Now we have to write the given data. So inlet pressure and temperature is 10 bar and 200 degrees centigrade. So inlet pressure P1 equal to 10 bar and inlet temperature T1 equal to 200 degrees centigrade. Back pressure or exit pressure equal to 0.5 bar. Throat diameter DT 12 millimeter. So we have to convert to meters. 12 into 10 to the power minus 3 meters. Then estimate the mass flow rate of steam. So we have to estimate the mass flow rate of steam in the nozzle M dot. So now we have to know the formula for calculating the mass flow rate of steam, m dot equal to AT CT divided by VT. So we know from the mass balance equation, mass flow rate equal to A1 C1 divided by V1 equal to A2 C2 divided by V2 equal to AT CT divided by VT. Here AT is the cross-sectional area of the throat, CT is the velocity of steam at throat, and VT is the specific volume of steam at throat in meter cube per kg. So for calculating the cross-sectional area of throat, we know AT equal to pi by 4 into DT square. Here DT is the diameter at the throat section. Then we have to find out CT, velocity of steam at throat section, equal to square root of 2000 into H1 minus HT. HT is the specific enthalpy of steam at throat, and H1 is the specific enthalpy of steam at the inlet, where VT is the specific volume of steam at throat in meter cube per kilogram, H1 is the specific enthalpy of steam at the inlet of the nozzle in kilojoule per kilogram, and HT equal to specific enthalpy of steam at the throat of the nozzle in kilojoule per किलोग्राम। At state 1, the initial pressure P1 equal to 10 bar and initial temperature T1 equal to 200 degrees centigrade. For calculating the value of N, we have to know the quality of steam. So from the Mollier diagram, we have to locate the state 1, P1 equal to 10 bar and T1 equal to 200 degrees centigrade. Okay, so 10 bar pressure, this is the 10 bar pressure line, and this is the 200 degree centigrade temperature. So both are intersecting at this point. So here we have to mark the point as 1. Now the point 1 or state 1, which is above the saturation curve. So the quality of steam is superheated at the entry of nozzle. Now, for calculating the velocity of steam at throat, we have to know the pressure of steam at throat section. So, from the critical pressure ratio equation, Pt by P1 equal to 2 by n plus 1, the whole power n by n minus 1. Here, the value of n equal to 1.3 because the steam is superheated at the inlet of the steam nozzle. Now, substituting the value of n equal to 1.3 in the critical pressure ratio equation, we get the critical pressure ratio Pt by P1 equal to 0.546. So, in our problem, they have given the initial pressure P1 equal to 10 bar. Now, substituting the value of P1 in this equation, we get the throat pressure Pt equal to 5.46 bar. Now, we can solve this problem using Mollier chart. At state 1, P1 equal to 10 bar and T1 equal to 200 degrees centigrade. So for calculating the value of H1, we have to plot state 1 in Mollier diagram. See, this is our Mollier diagram. We all know the y-axis represents specific enthalpy in kilojoule per kilogram and the x-axis represents specific entropy in kilojoule per kilogram Kelvin. This dark curve indicates the saturation curve. So here we have to locate the point 1. So pressure P1 equal to 10 bar. Here we have the 10 bar pressure line. So this is the 10 bar pressure line and T1 equal to 200 degrees centigrade. So this one is 200 degrees centigrade. So both the curves are intersecting at this point. So here we have to locate the point 1. So from point 1, we have to draw a line parallel to x-axis towards y-axis and measure the corresponding specific enthalpy value. H1 equal to 2830 kilojoule per kilogram. Then we know at throat section Pt equal to 5.46 bar. So this value is calculated from the critical pressure ratio equation. So now we have to identify 5.46 bar pressure line. So here this is the 5.46 bar pressure line. And we know the expansion process takes place in nozzle is isentropic. Therefore, entropy at point 1, throat and exit are constant. Therefore, from state 1, I have to draw a vertical line downwards. So, both the pressure Pt line and the vertical isentropic process line are intersecting at a point. So, that point is T. So now from point T, draw a corresponding line towards y-axis and measure the corresponding value of specific enthalpy HT equal to 2720 kilojoule per kilogram. Also, calculating the mass flow rate, we have to know the value of specific volume of steam at the throat section. See here, this is the 0.5 meter cube per kilogram specific volume line. This is 0.2 meter cube per kg specific volume line. So our point is in between these two. So approximately we have to measure the value of specific volume at throat section. So at throat section, the specific volume Vt equal to 0.33 meter cube per kilogram. We know the velocity of steam at throat, Ct equal to square root of 2000 into h1 minus ht. We have find out the values of h1 equal to 2830 kilojoule per kilogram and ht equal to 2720 kilojoule per kilogram from Mollier diagram. Now substituting these two values in the velocity equation, we get Ct equal to 469.04 meters per second. Now I have to find out the cross sectional area of throat AT. AT equal to pi by 4 into dt square. In our problem, they have given dt equal to 12 mm or 12 into 10 to the power minus 3 meters. Now substituting the value of dt in this equation, we get area equal to 1.13 into 10 to the power minus 4 meter square. Now we have to find out the mass flow rate of steam m dot, which is equal to AT into CT divided by VT. So the value of AT already calculated, it is 1.13 into 10 to the power minus 4 meter square. And CT equal to 469.04 meters per second is calculated by using velocity equation. Then from the Mollier diagram, we have found out the value of specific volume of steam at throat equal to 0.33 meter cube per kg. Now substituting these three values in the mass flow rate equation, we get mass flow rate M equal to 0.1606 kilogram per second. So our answer is mass flow rate of steam M dot equal to 0.1606 kg per second. Thank you.